Hello, Joan of Heart here, and I wanted to take you today on an adventure outside the Playhouse, where I traveled to Sweetwater in Fort Wayne, Indiana. It was actually for their event, Gearfest 2023. I traveled along with Emily Harris of Getoffset, and I was there helping her film for the content that she was creating with guitars and other gear that was there at this event. They had many different booths of different guitars, different technology, new tech, different ways of filming even with cameras and green screen. It was a really interesting experience to be able to see how my friends and peers who are YouTubers record in some very spontaneous situations, and seeing how they adapted was really helpful for me in thinking of sometimes my being outside of the Playhouse and recording things myself as future ideas. I wanted to thank Sweetwater for having us out. I wanted to thank Emily Harris for bringing me along as well. And I'm going to put Getoffset's channel in the description below. I definitely think that you could check out her channel and all the content she filmed from the Gearfest. And yeah, it was a lot of fun. So some of the things that you're going to see today is the encouragement of my friends to myself in some of my off time. Hey, go record stuff yourself. You know, you're helping us, but do stuff for you too. So I was like, well, I didn't really anticipate what I should record, but yeah, I took a stab at it because, again, nothing ventured, nothing gained, and it's a learning experience. So any challenge is really just a opportunity in disguise, right? So you learn by doing. So yeah, the footage will be like from my iPad, from my iPhone. I used my, you know, H5N Zoom along for sometimes direct audio or in the area, and my trusty tripod. So you'll have moments where I am recording in trying to anticipate, okay, well, maybe I can do a voiceover here. Maybe this can be for certain social media aspects. And also in other instances, it is the moments where we were kind of just having fun. So I think those moments also are equally good to share. So here is basically my adventure, and I hope you enjoy it. And I am going to say that it was great that Sweetwater asked me to be a part of their affiliate program. So yes, there will be affiliate links in description below going forward and from here on. And if you'd like to know how to use affiliate links to support your favorite channel, I'll give you a quick walkthrough. On your favorite content creator's video, there'll be links to products they may feature or gear they may use themselves to create their content they list. I will also have a generic link put to Sweetwater as to give you freedom of choice. So let's click the link and it should take you to the Sweetwater website. Once on the website, you have a window of 14 minutes to purchase any gear that you'd like. A small percentage of that is set aside by Sweetwater, but they do not send us an email basically saying that we used your link. So here I am now saying thank you so much. I really appreciate the effort that you make in taking these extra steps with such thoughtful intention. And I'm looking forward to any of the opportunities of working together in the future with Sweetwater. And I appreciate some of the things that they told me, in which they want to see more people like myself and like other people out there and doing things like this. So I appreciated that.
Well, that's where I see things just a little differently. Contractor, no, I will not bow to any sponsor. Maybe I'm wrong on this one, but for me, the beast doesn't include selling out. I can't talk about it anymore. It's giving me a headache.
Here, take two of these.
Yes, and it's the choice of a new generation.
Well, I guess without further ado, let's go. This here, which was a lot of fun, I think this is one of the highlights for me, the Evans Hybrid Sensory Percussion Sound System, in which you can take your drum kit and really turn it into anything. Thank you. And here's where the mischief began. In anticipation of coming to Gearfest, I was thinking, well, if there's going to be effects pedals possibly there, different booths or brands, why don't I maybe bring a mic and my XLR female to instrument cable, and why don't I just put my voice through some effects pedals and cause some chaos? I saw that the VOD booth was there and Tom Cram, I definitely knew was game. So I walked up and I said, hey, do you mind if I put my voice through your pedal board? And he was like, no, go ahead. Yeah, definitely. He encouraged this and let the calamity begin. Thought to put my voice through a envelope filter. So let's do this. Well, Emily tweaks in the background.
Keep going, keep going.
If you are new to this channel, this is your first video. I am a, I guess, animator, and I like to take effects pedals, bring them to life, and together we kind of work together to figure out how their pedal functions and make music together. It's silly all the time, we're having fun, and we hope that in watching you also have fun too. So let's get back to the story again. It is at this point in our story, or journey, that something unexpected happened. A love story in which I fell in love with a guitar while I was at Sweetwater, which was completely unplanned and not something that normally happens for me.
It will be mine. Oh, yes. It will be mine.
Normally, it's effects pedals that I usually gravitate to and obsess about, which, you know, why we're most of the time while we're here. Yeah. I got a period of time every day, 20, 30 minutes, to play this guitar. And historically, I guess it was predictable because I love blue guitars. That is known to friends of mine. It's kind of a hierarchy of colors, really. It's blue, it's purple, and then it's red. But this guitar had a combination of both blue and purple, and it was a burst. To be able to play that guitar and the way it sounded with the pickups and just the way it felt overall was just an experience I'd never had before. So I had moments where I was kind of feeling incredibly grateful in the moment to be there and to be able to have that kind of experience with a guitar because I'd never had before. I didn't think that would happen to me, but, you know, they always say when you're not looking, that's when it happens. So in watching this clip, you'll probably definitely notice how much I fell in love with that guitar. Is it loud? We're almost there. We'll see how loud it can get. In one of my free roam moments, I swung by the Sure booth, and I was looking for Yuri. I'd previously talked to Yuri and Paul on another occasion when we were chatting and filming content and whatnot, but I wanted to then come by again and myself ask about Beto Playhouse and how can I improve the overall quality? Is it the microphones, or if I go outside of the Playhouse, how can I obviously, either through microphone or post-processing, how can I eliminate unwanted noise and unpredictable scenarios? But when I showed up and looked around, I couldn't find Yuri anywhere, but I kind of was hearing some noise. And when I did find him, I saw that he was walking around with this pedal receiver from Shure, in which you could walk up to 200 feet with playing your instrument, whether it be a guitar or a guitar or anything, and free roam and walk around. And, it led to a really interesting conversation that was a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoy that conversation as much as I did. We're here at Sweetwater, and I am here at the Sure booth. And I want to hear all the gear talk about this
guitar. As I'm holding a Roland guitar at the Sure booth. So hi, my name is Yuri, and I work for Sure. And we have all sorts of really, really cool stuff here. And right now, I'm using this guitar to show off our wireless GLX Plus system, which is this guy right here. I'm shredding away at this guitar here. And just messing around, causing noise, and this is using this transmitter.
Which I appreciate.
Yep. So just going into this transmitter right here, and then we're moving over to that guitar pedal receiver, and then straight to an app. So I can actually walk pretty much anywhere in this room and straight away.
And so far, you've been walking around and just causing chaos wherever you've gone.
Yes, just
He's walked in front of, like, UA is having some kind of, like, you know, we're doing some kind of demo. He totally, just likes, like, you know, you think John Travolta, he's, like, playing the guitar and going.
Literally, she's like, okay, so, like, you're playing keyboards, you're at UA, and I'm sitting there walking around, and this is, literally, this is the shot right here. And then, like, the UA guy's like, you're the camera.
Oh, surprise jazz.
Yeah.
Oh, you caused
exactly,
it.
Exactly. But now, here I'm in the confines of my own booth.
That's why I came over to spend some time with you. You had a cancellation, so I was like, you know what, why don't I spend some time with Yuri? And I really love, obviously, to see what you can do with this, because but how many sounds that you can do. And of course, I love the beeps and the boops. He is not a spokesperson for Roland, so anything that's misinformation, not responsible.
I mean, I don't know. Like, this is a beautiful instrument.
It is. I've seen a similar one that's kind of white. I've seen the band Ghost, and their key player would pretty much come out at some point and do, like, a whole, like, almost guitar solo on the keyboard. Yeah.
I mean, it has a couple of built-in sounds. I don't think it's based on any specific Roland synthesizer that people would be familiar with, but, you know, it's pretty user-friendly. I think the coolest thing about it that I found out, but I haven't played with much yet, is that all of these switches right here are programmable. So I can use them to switch sounds, or I can use them to change settings.
Yeah, move the octaves up and down.
Yeah, yeah. And the cool thing is, like, it's got this little slider here. This one causes, like, vibrato.
So wait, you can do kind of like a pseudo-saxophone, kind of like careless whispers you can just go into right now. Yeah.
Yeah.
second. Yeah, it almost did.
It's been a lot of fun causing chaos.
No, I can tell. I can tell. Like, when I was trying to... I actually was coming to the share booth because, you know, I wanted to talk with you. And I was like, well, where did he go? And I'm hearing some sounds, and I hear this coming from the amp that's below where the iPad is. And I'm like, wait, if he's playing, well, it's not the UA booth. Well, let me look around. And then I walk over to the Alterio booth, and I see him standing there. It's like, that's where he is.
He's got to be within 200 feet of this area.
Or the other one.
I'm hearing guitar, right? So we are. Yeah, come hang out at Shure anytime.
Yeah, I appreciate
it. With all of our wireless toys.
Oh, you know I would play. I would literally take any of these mics and put them through my pedal board.
Nice.
Like, I would love that. So I appreciate you spending time with me and, of course, play the guitar. And thank you for, you know, at least having me here, Sweetwater. And I love kind of bringing everyone here along with me to the journey. And I look forward to editing this and then sharing it.
Until the next time we meet, be the good you wish to see in the world. Be excellent to each other. Be seeing you.